Welcome back to News Center One. Today, well, I told you we're going to be joined with Nicole, and here she is from the YMCA. I know, right? So we have our wellness director here, and you're talking about food journaling this morning.
Right. A lot of folks, when they start a diet and exercise program, they don't see instant results, and they just kind of get frustrated and kind of drop off after a few weeks if they make it that long, and they wonder, you know, gosh, I eat so healthy. But a tip is to kind of write down everything that you eat, and I learned this years ago, and it really plays a big role in seeing how far you've come or tracking what you can do.
Sure. Yeah, because I have actually done this before, and I was the same way. I thought, I don't eat that bad, right?
And then I started. And then you go back, and you look at it, and you're like, gosh, I had, you know, ooh, maybe I shouldn't have that bite.
What? Or I didn't realize how many calories were in, you know, cheese or whatever it is.
Exactly. Cheese is a big one, especially if you eat it standing up. A lot of people think it doesn't count. But if you bite it, you need to write it.
Absolutely.
Log it.
So do you guys have these journals available at the Y?
Yes. Yep. We do have these at the Y. And this is just, you know, a notebook, basically.
Sure.
And it does have the lines in it that say you exercise on this page or food on this page. But any kind of notebook will do. And there's even like a smartphone app, MyFitnessPal.
Oh, yeah.
And those are excellent.
Yeah, so tell me about the MyFitnessPal.
You log on, you create an account, and it's got everything designed down to breakfast, lunch, dinner, and even exercise.
Okay.
So the more foods that you put in, it'll recognize and it'll keep those foods popping back up. And there's even a barcode scanner. You can scan
your calories, how much you're taking in.
Mm-hmm. And then just put in, you know, how many servings of that did you have?
Okay.
And, you know, things
and that's
like that.
Another big thing.
Oh,
you don't realize, because, you know, when I was tracking it that one time, I thought, you know, a cup, and you're like, that's not very much after all.
All I had was a bowl of cereal for breakfast, but your bowl of cereal,
big old guy.
Like five servings. And so it really opens your eyes when you start tracking things. And then when you get stuck, you can go back and look. Oh, well, I had the most success here. This was a good week for me. I really felt great. This is what I was eating. And you can, you know, see, did I have any processed foods? How many whole foods did I have? Was I eating my fruits and vegetables? And it's also a good way to just track water and start something easy like that. You know, just make a tally mark for each piece of fruit and vegetable that you have. You know, start simple and then keep kind of going.
Sure.
And then with exercise, you can look back and see, gosh, this is why my running program is stalling, because I really haven't been progressing in the weeks prior to it. Or, you know, my strength training, this is what I was doing. You know, a lot of folks kind of make fun of journaling, but it's excellent. It's a definite way to break through a plateau and get where you want to be.
Yeah, and it definitely makes you accountable for everything you're putting in your body and everything.
Especially if you would you like to look at what I've eaten? If you let somebody else look at your journal.
Exactly, your dirty laundry hanging out there. Okay, very good. So here's your tip. Start food journaling.
Start food and exercise journaling, yes.
Absolutely. Okay, thank you so much for stopping in.